केरल के वायनाड में तेज बारिश की वजह से सोमवार देर रात चार अलग अलग जगहों पर लैंडस्लाइड हुई। रात 2 बजे से सुबह 6 बजे के बीच हुए लैंडस्लाइड में चार गांव बह गए। मुंडकई, चूरलमाला, अट्टामाला और नूरपूजा में घर, पुल, सड़कें और गाड़ियां भी बह गईं। अब तक 114 लोगों की मौत हो चुकी है, 116 अस्पताल में है, जबकि 98 से ज्यादा लोगों के लापता होने की खबर है। बता दें कि रेस्क्यू के लिए आर्मी, एयरफोर्स, SDRF और NDRF की टीम मौके पर मौजूद है। वहीं कन्नूर से आर्मी के 222 जवानों को वायनाड के लिए रवाना किया गया है। एयरफोर्स के 2 हेलीकॉप्टर भी रेस्क्यू के लिए भेजे गए हैं, लेकिन बारिश के चलते उन्हें कोझिकोड लौटना पड़ा। इधर केरल सरकार ने इस हादसे के बाद राज्य में 2 दिन की राजकीय शोक की घोषणा की है।
Just now I can give you only the thing information that you know around 130 soldiers under the leadership of Captain Tushar of 23 Madras Regiment and Captain Saurabh of 2 Madras Regiment from Pangod Military Station are moving ahead towards Wayanad. Most of them will be airlifted by Indian Air Force aircraft and to Kozhikode, and the rest will be proceeding on road. And we are all aware that since in the morning, as per the requirement by the government, Kerala government, Defence Security Corps Centre, Kannur, with their 200 soldiers have already gone there. And the Territorial Army, 122 Infantry Battalion, Madras, they are also there. They reached there around 12. And it seems ward number 10 is in a real bad shape. And they have been doing their best, and because the bridge is not there, it's really very difficult for them to move, and they were trying to reach out on the wires, the ropes that were provided by NDRF. And early in the morning, our Air Force people from Sulur to helicopters have reached there, but due to the bad weather, they are not able to, because of the poor visibility, they are not able to reach out there. They have tried some 2-3 sorties. I'm also waiting for the updates. I have already sent a message to them. And of course, from Erimala, we have our Navy people have already gone, who are good at crossing rivers and all that. So our defense sector, defense people are all working in tandem with whatever rescue operations is possible, along with the other rescue troop members. You know, they are all working together to help the people there. It's really in a very bad shape, and the place is in really havoc. So that's a great problem. You know, reachability is difficult, and the bridges are not there, and that's really bad.